to the Mermalair!
Away!
How you doing, Zig?
I'm doing alright. How about you, Merrick?
Yeah, pretty much the same for the most part. Can't really complain.
Yeah.
Tomorrow is the day that my freedom of being home alone ends.
Oh, yeah.
And then I gotta contend with all sorts of stuff.
Yeah.
I keep forgetting that I changed my background on my desktop. Because I kind of got tired of that. I kind of got tired of my old thing. And now
Persona 5 one.
Yeah, and now every time I switch to it, I'm like, I forgot I changed this.
Yeah.
It's fucking funny, I tell you what. Anyway, yeah. Tonight we finally... What's up?
Oh, no, nothing, never mind.
No, you said... No. You go for it.
It was like when I switched my old background to the current one I have. Like, I used to have the absolutely disgusting reaction image and whatnot.
The absolutely disgusting... How come I'm thinking of whatchamacallit? Something out of, like, regular show.
I don't know. It would probably be, like, something out of, like, regular show if they actually did, like, whatchamacallit to it and shit.
Really?
Like a parody of it and whatnot, where, you know, they have, like, the news guy standing behind the house.
Whatchamacallit, that dude who freaked out over the lair of Darthon or whatever it was called.
Huh.
You know what I'm talking about, right?
Roll the sponge.
Lair of Darthon.
When they bought like that.
Oh yeah, when they bought that
like shitty RPG. And then like, oh, we want to get a refund. They showed
There's
like.
Nothing like the smell of bubbles in the morning.
Or was
Smells
it?
Like,
yeah,
or
yeah.
Wasn't that? Was it a different one? There was like a dude who was like, ugh, or whatever the fuck. He makes like a horribly disgusted face. I think that might have been that one. I think after they like showed him the pieces and whatnot.
Yeah.
But yeah, not today. Today I couldn't really complain about what was going on. Honestly, I'm kind of I have better feelings of
Let
working
me teach
on
you how to bowl a bubble. Press this button and you'll bowl a bubble that can knock down robots from a safe distance.
Ha 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 ha.
Remember though, the bubble bowl only works on things that are close to the ground.
Got it.
Thank you for that, Bubble Buddy. I totally needed that information because I was already doing the bubble bowl, like, multiple times before you showed up.
Hey, you.
Yeah.
Pepper needs to do laundry.
Anyway, I honestly have more, feeling to work on stuff than play some games.
Oh, that's cool.
Cause like I'll put it to you like this, right? I was playing some games today when I had some spare time earlier.
Yeah.
But like, you know, like how everything in its power was like stopping it somewhat.
Yeah.
Because oh yeah, right, the police station.
Mhm.
I forgot that was a thing.
Yeah.
On free balloon day.
Flash, sponge wearing 5 pairs of underwear coming through. I feel like a new sponge.
Oh, come on. Come on, let me break in. Damn it. What in theory is stopping you there? Only the invisible wall. Come on.
Yeah.
Like you could hop, like I could hop over this fence.
You can hop over that fence. And just be like, I want that spatula. I want that spatula, boyo.
Oh yeah, right. Sand Mountain's also a thing.
Oh yeah.
That's another level, because it's not really a level. It's mostly just those little slides and whatnot.
Yeah.
Wow,
Life is Mermaid extreme. Man and Barnacle Boy, my heroes. Hit me with a water ball. Hit me.
There they are.
Yeah, we don't do that stuff anymore, kid.
Is that the TV repairman?
No, it's that excited sponge kid again.
Oh, are you sure he can't fix the TV?
Oh my god, that's not Mermaid Man.
Mermaid Man, 'twould be my greatest honor to fix your television.
Goodie!
Hey, sponge kid, you really want to help out?
Oh boy, would I?
I like how a lot of the characters feel like they're season one counterparts.
Okay then.
Rather than like season two and three. When this game came out around the time.
We've got a little problem with some robots down in the Mermalair.
Yeah, I would say like around season
Are you sure
three,
you're up to
four.
This task?
There he is, Zig. I'm over
here.
Absolutely, Barnacle Boy.
Well, go over to the couch to access the Mermalair.
I'm over here.
We'll meet you down there.
Is it pudding night yet?
Pudding,
yes. That's me.
I'm over here.
Elder abuse. I remember like you could like get the camera inside of these like inside of her head and it was like fucking disturbing. Cause she had like a face inside of her face. There he is, Old Man Jenkins!
Old Man Jenkins!
I love the young people.
What did I miss?
Whoa, what's going on?
Whoa.
Oh boy. Oh boy. I'm excited for this. Who's this guy? Is this a worker here?
Yeah, probably a nurse.
I love how everything inside of this place is like completely fine and untouched from the robots. But the Mermalair has been invaded.
Yeah. They somehow got into the Mermalair.
Through the back door, maybe.
Remember, Lair has a back door. Oh, wait, no, yeah, you're right.
Remember, how does the invisible boatmobile get out?
Yeah, that just, like, sprang up, like, right then and there.
Remember, we could actually find the invisible boatmobile here.
Yeah.
Where's the button? That's odd. Those scared tikis didn't go away, huh?
Must be a glitch.
I could tell you about glitches today.
I got glitches in me britches.
Exactly. Mermaid Man and Barnacle Boy.
You know, I was playing Crash One Saturday earlier.
You shouldn't sneak up on Mermaid Man like that. His heart's not so good.
Yeah.
Come to think of it, nothing on him is that good anymore.
His heart's not so good.
Sorry, Mermaid Man. It's just that I'm always so excited to see you two. Standing in your awesome presence gives me the chills of justice. See? I've got goosebumps on my...
All right, kid.
You don't have to tell us more about R.L. Stine. Please, stop.
Well, I really want a new pair of sunglasses. Patrick sat on my old ones.
That's not what I meant.
Actually, it's a good thing you showed up. Young sponge of goodness.
It is?
It is?
Yes. A bunch of evil robots have taken over the Mermalair security system. It's up to you to shut it down and stop them.
He's trying so hard to be Mermaid.
Well, why him? We're perfectly capable superheroes.
Because it's Thursday and we have a whole bunch of doctor's appointments.
Ah, fish sticks. I forgot.
Go talk to the Mermalair computer in the next room. She'll tell you what to do.
I accept this awesome responsibility, Mermaid Man. You won't be disappointed.
To the doctor's office! Away!
It's Thursday. We have a bunch of doctor's appointments. I love this game.
To the chiropractor! Away!
I love this game so much.
I know.
It's like...
Yeah, no, I like it too. Again, it's like one of my favorites as like a kid and whatnot.
It's
you know
not
what I'm
just
saying?
Any sponge, it's super sponge.
Another so Sly Cooper-esque contraption.
Fresh like a spring breeze.
It's still one of my favorites. Even for like a licensed game, this is like uncharacteristically good.
Yeah.
Well, Super Sponge was also okay.
Yeah, Super Sponge was alright. I would say like some of the later levels were kind of like bullshit and whatnot, if you ask me. From what I remember, at least.
Oh, this same thing is gonna take. I'm like, now reach it with my bowls. Yeah. Go on! But yeah, no, you want to talk about glitches. I was playing Crash Twinsanity earlier, right?
Yeah.
Honestly, it's one of my favorite Crash games, but... Oh, did I discover, like, horrifying secrets about it that no sane individual should know about the game?
Yeah.
Basically... Uh-oh. Uh oh. New robot type. What? Wait, why does the cowboy make the dog noises when I whack him?
Get along, little doggy.
Yeehaw. It's ironic because it releases all the little doggies to kill shit.
Mm-hmm.
There we go. That dealt with him.
Hey, Monument.
Hey, Monument. How's it going? It's so good to see you. What is it?
Check it out when you have a chance.
Well, number one, I can use this fresh pair of underwear right now.
Fresh, yeah. Like a spring breeze.
And I see a little thing we have to bungee jump over.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, Crash Twinsanity, right?
Right, yeah.
You want to know what I found out about it?
What about it?
So... Apparently, the way the game works, right? Is weird. So, I found out that you can repeat levels if you needed to.
Uh-huh.
But they don't work in... They don't work in a way you'd think they would. So
okay.
it resets the game state. Like you can watch
like
cutscenes over and over again if you wanted to through this. And I don't know if this is a glitch or not, right?
You just met the Sponginator.
Because I
Crash
took that crash as a wait what?
Punishment fetish.
I feel like a new sponge.
What crash?
There's a monument over here.
Twinsanity?
I think just Crash, the character in general.
Crash Bandicoot 2. Cortex Strikes Back. Speaking of that, I actually got... Speaking of, Cortex Strikes Back, guess what I bought? Guess what I bought as soon as my, little break started?
It's about
Secret
time.
Secret Fortress.
Yeah.
Wrinkly superheroes, Mermaid Man, ooh, and Barnacle Boy.
Well, technically, you know, finally for the Crash Bandicoot.
Bandicoot. Not just the kind of happy you feel in the front of your knees, but the kind of happy you feel in the back of your elbow. Oh, you'll never believe what's been happening.
Yeah, I've already been briefed by the geriatric duo. Those two old coots sent me in to get updated with the Mermalair computer. But since you're here now, I'll let you do it. It's right over there.
They said Squidwarden.
Look at this place. I mean, police. Would it kill them to lay down
a few
snow
rugs?
Oh, look who it is! And all this
it's
wasted
Captain
space?
Magma.
How did those two old fogies make all this?
Krakatoa!
Oh, that's easy. In episode 27, the Mermalair is invaded by the digging monsters of Bermuda, and they...
Never mind!
Do the tricks, Carrie!
Yeah, don't be a bitch!
Squidward! I should...
Come on!
I see you, you fucking mouse. Yeah, as soon as I say I see you, he runs away.
Yeah.
They know.
Right. I'll see you later.
They fucking know. Anyway, so what's yeah, up? You can repeat the game, but it resets the game.
Oh, okay.
And you can't really do it to, you can't really set it up so like, oh, you can, all right. It's hard to explain how this works exactly because here's what I was trying to do. I was trying to get a gem and then not have to complete the level because I didn't feel like playing through the rest of the game up to the point I got, because there's a shortcut that takes you back to the first area, right?
Mm-hmm.
But no, that's not how the game works.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, you have to go back. If you save and quit and reload, it doesn't save your, like, item progress.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, and no. And I thought I was on the cusp of discovery because I thought I got an extra... Haven't you done this in...
Fresh, like
haven't
a
done this
breeze.
In a while. This might be nice. What's this? Chuckle, but yeah, wait, I want you. You sent me this one back when we were doing whatchamacallit, Death's Door Monument. Chuckle Vision. That's funny. I was thinking of that as soon as you joined. Yeah, the ice and the cream and whatnot, right? I'm gonna sell the cheap of the ice and the cream. And he was the yeah, he was the mayor's he was like the mayor's brother or something. I'm gonna sell the cheaper ice to the cream and you're not gonna stop me. Let me get a new one. Ain't that funny? As soon as I think of Chuckle Vision.
It appears. Just like that.
It's odd.
Leave it to us. I'm great at throwing things.
All you have to do is pick up a throw fruit and throw it into each of those funnel machines.
Don't you mean a watermelon?
Throw the throw fruit. You might want to be quick about it. I tend to explode. I mean, they tend to explode.
Yes, that is supposed to be Mermaid Man Monument.
Yeah.
He sounds nothing like,
Yeah, I know you! You're
I guess they just couldn't get, Ernest Borgnine or whatever,
you know
what I'm saying?
Gonna need a lot more power to activate the hydroacoustic Doppler modulator.
I forget, because I know it's also the same guy who does Mr. Krabs in this game, too, and shit.
But they did get, Barnacle Boy.
You think you can handle this?
Yeah.
I can see Squidward's house from up here. And he's not wearing any pants. Oh, wait, he never wears pants.
Now listen up. There are 8 cylinders over there. If you throw something at the cylinders, it'll turn around to the power
Joe
side.
Joe White, that's his name.
Turn all 8 cylinders
Joe
around
White.
To the power side and I'll give
Joe
you a reward.
White.
Joe White.
Sorry, what was that? I was watching Squidward.
Just start turning those cylinders.
He actually voiced Chris Redfield in the Resident Evil remake.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Sure gotta carry a lot of stuff around.
Oh, we got Barnacle Boy. Be calm, my beating heart.
We got Mermaid Man at home. Mermaid Man at home. Be still, my beating rib cage. And your bib and high chair. First off, I want to be called Barnacle Man. I'm tired of playing second fiddle to a man who wears a bra. That was sarcasm, by the way. Evil! Where is it? Evil.
Ah, well done. Now there's enough power.
What do you need all
he
that
He actually
power
did the
for?
Evil cry before.
Why, my foot bath, of course. Here, have a golden spatula.
Oh my god.
Oh boy.
Also, wait, Patrick has teeth in this. Like, individual teeth.
Ouch. Oh. It went boom. Oh. Oh, another one. Gooch.
What was the magic words? Alabala.
I don't think SpongeBob's underwear fits quite right.
It used to be Alakazam.
Alakazam, Baba, Baga, Lava, Dama.
Patrick's always had teeth, but not like individually, like, you know, carved ones that he has in his mouth now. And then Patrick, like Donkey Kong, has fucking, whatchamacallit, like retractable teeth.
Play as a whistle.
He did, but he had, like, individually in the OG game, really. A la Buzza. Von Riesenschneider. Aw, oh, shit. Anyway. But yeah, no, so I but am I glitching before I start the episode of Chucklevision? In all of my, like, weird glitching. Yes, I'm a Taurus. In all my weird glitching of, whatchamacallit.
Yeah.
Crash Bandicoot, Crash Twin Sanity.
Now I can get some sleep.
I somehow thought I got an extra power crystal. But no, that wasn't the case, because it takes away all of your item progress if you save and quit before you get to the next world crate. So, oh, okay. Yeah, if you get a collectible and you save and quit, you don't get that item. You gotta play through the whole level again. The Mermaid Man legit makes me angry. And the worst part is that since they didn't get anybody back to re-record their lines, and they unfortunately can't get Ernest Borgnine back to redo his lines because he's passed away.
Yeah.
That's what makes it even worse. At least we got Chris Redfield for our troubles, but hey.
Yeah.
Humble Beginning. Did this come out before the remake of Resident Evil?
No, I think this came out after, Resident Evil. I know that was 2002, and this was, like, more so, like, 2004, I believe it was?
Ooh! Again!
I
want to say 2004.
I don't know what to say. but I will say it anyway.
October 31st, 2003.
And then Resident Evil Remake was 2002.
I feel like a new sponge. Sparkly.
Sorry, did you already go over your glitching and whatnot? I kind of zoned out for a second.
What I was saying was I thought I had an extra power crystal.
Technically
speaking, I restart the game 3 times because, I missed a gem in this level. And I thought, as soon as I figured out that, I have to play through everything again, even if I get to it and reload my save, that's when I stopped playing the game for a bit. I'm like, I'm done right now. I love this game, but I can't right now. Now I just gotta remember where all the fucking gems are, and I'll be set.
Yeah.
Cause straight up, right? Mm-hmm. Aside from, alright, like, you remember my Crash 2 stream where I was just trying to get 100% because why the fuck not? I like Crash 2 well enough to do
it.
Oh yeah,
and that was something.
The amount of backtracking in that game just to 100% it. Like, you know, Crash 2 is not a bad game, right?
Yeah, it's a pretty good game and whatnot.
It's just very short, and due to that, you can't really... Due to that, well, I just did something awesome accidentally. What'd you do? Because it's so short, right? Like, and trying to get 100% and everything, you have to, like, play through the game, like, worlds, like, I don't know how many times.
There's nothing like the smell
just to get it all, right?
Smells like...
Yeah.
Honestly, I prefer the way Crash to Insanity did it, because, you know why?
Why's that?
You get stuff for getting the gems, it's not just bragging rights. Or, like, an achievement or trophy in, like, the, you know, the Insane Trilogy. Square, and this sponge is
bomb.
What's up?
Or, like, you know, that little secret ending when you get all the gems and shit.
Oh, yeah. You still get a secret, ending in, to Insanity, but you know what else you get to?
What?
You get to see, like, bonus features and stuff.
Oh, that's cool.
I know, you can just look them up online, whatever. It's different when you can, like, you know, play the game for them. You know what I mean? Back in the past when you didn't really have internet.
Yeah.
Like a Dragon Ishin in the gunman style. I did a running knee attack to bust down a wall, and then some sequent bullets fired from above swung the next door open as soon as I broke the wall.
Wow.
It's pretty badass, actually.
Yeah.
Let me take out this fucking robot without the, I gotta get that stupid, you know, seeker bubble or whatever. The bubble strike or whatever the frick.
Yeah.
But, like, you don't just get, like, all sorts of stuff. You get, like, in, like, Liga Dragon, Ishin is at the Edo Japan Yakuza game. Zero out of 10. Dumbest baby. Multiple styles on that one as well.
Ooh.
Fresh like a spring breeze.
Wild dancer.
Wild dancer. 01010010010. Which is a gun in one hand, a sword in the other. Sugar gets to look at seltzer water. Tap, tap, tap. Tap, tap. Idiot. Tap, tap. Oh, I forgot to hit one of those things.
Yeah.
So yeah, you're just like the character. You're just like a couple of the characters from Dark Cloud and Dark Cloud 2. With sword in one hand, gun in the other. Sounds cool.
Yeah, that sounds pretty cool, actually.
You must jump between the two. You jump one way, shoot. You jump another, you hit somebody with your sword. You cut off a limb or two.
In order for me to regain control of the security system, you need to press all the override buttons spread throughout the Mermalair.
Who voices this computer? It sounds familiar.
The first one is here.
Press the buttons! Got it!
When you have pressed them all, you should return here to press the master shutdown button. You will be rewarded.
Return here. Got it.
Are you listening to me?
Listening. Got it.
When he does the fucking Spongebob, hey, Galaxy. When Tom Kenny breaks the Spongebob voice.
Oh, that's, Carolyn Lawrence.
There's nothing like the smell of bubbles in the morning. Smells like...
Oh, really?
Victory.
Yeah.
I knew it sounded familiar. Press the master shutdown button and lower the bridge. Lower the bridges to the villain containment system area. Ooh. Mm-hmm. Classic.
Classic.
Also, one of the gunman styles heat action is literally grabbing a guy, slamming it into a wall, and shooting him straight in the gut.
Ooh.
And once again, they don't bleed out.
Either they have, like, iron guts and whatnot. Like, lead bellies and all that shit.
You're going in the iron gut.
Gary, I see you've made your way down to the deepest recesses of the Mermalair.
Meow.
Oh, you took the elevator. How do I get to the top?
There's the back door.
Meow.
Yeah, I see.
Mother has you run towards a guy, slide into his legs, and fling him in the air and shoot him twice while sliding under them.
You're
and
right.
Them,
I bet those tunnels will
under them
take
and
me
them
up
in
to
the air.
Top. Good thinking,
the name.
Gary.
What do you mean the name? Oh, the name of the heat action?
Oh, be joyful.
Oh, come on now. You could be more joyful than that.
Right.
Give us a little smile. Come on.
Love opening presents.
You were such a happy person when you were... No.
It shines.
You were such a happy person. You ever get that? You ever get that? You ever get that shit? Oh, you were such a happy person when you were X age.
Not really, no.
Yeah, probably not you, because, like, you don't have shitty parents.
No. I think... I was told to, like, hey, why don't you smile and shit by a fucking, By some guy on a bike and shit.
Why don't you smile?
It's like, hey, why don't you smile? Come on, show me a smile. And it's like, dude, what the fuck? I don't know, dude.
There it is.
Chuckled at that shit.
There it is. Was he like, there it is?
Nah, he just kind of rode off and shit.
He rode off into the sunset.
He rode off into a sunset and into the seas. I'm kidding. I wish that did happen.
You could fish too and cook the fish. Cook with the fish again. I should play like a dragon. It sounds like fun.
Here.
So you're saying I can have a farm? So you're saying I can play Starbound in? I can play Starbound, but on a city planet.
Sure.
But it's got like It's got like regular RPG mechanics.
Yeah, I guess so.
Son of a bitch, I'm in. Not so much a farm, it is a garden. Hmm. So you're saying I can be a hillbilly in Yakuza Like a Dragon?
Yeah.
You live on a farm! I live in a penthouse!
You live on a farm with cows and pigs!
I don't like your big talk. Your condescending talk.
Fresh like a spring breeze.
Plus you get to rescue cats and dogs and they have them as pets.
Oh, that's nice.
There's nothing like the smell of bubbles
so
in the morning.
So it's just like Shenmue. Like
victory.
SpongeBob just fucking died there.
SpongeBob's fucking scared.
So like a dragon is literally Shenmue, except good. No, I'm not gonna take that. Shenmue's a good game.
A bit outdated, yeah, but still, I like
Wait, this isn't Shenmue.
I hate golf.
Years ago, I was Chinese.
Fresh like a
Years
spring
ago,
breeze.
I was Chinese.
Do you remember the day when the snow turned to rain?
Yes.
Ariel.
Ariel.
What's up, man?
I feel like a new sponge.
Do you know any sailors?
You're gonna play darts for your information. Hey there, y'all. How are you doing today? It's good to... Oh, that's...
Don't forget to hit that button.
That's terrible to hear.
Yeah.
Thank you for the drink. You are so kind.
Anytime.
You gotta help that thirsty guy out.
Somehow, I don't think he needs a hand.
I was looking to see that.
I will concede it's definitely
the... About asking about sailors and driving forklifts for 60 hours. I'll give them that. They have that down there.
I feel like if there was no Shenmue, there wouldn't be a Yakuza, so...
Probably.
Because it's literally just like, you know, Yakuza, yeah. But not fucking, you know. Also, like, saying, like, oh, yeah, you only get to talk to people. That's like saying Star Control 2 is a bad game, and all because all you do is talk to aliens in it.
Mm-hmm. Well, you can still fight them and whatnot, but that's only a handful of damage.
Yeah, you don't really need to do a lot of the fighting in order to...
Yeah.
Thankfully. But like...
0 out of 10. Dumbest baby.
Fresh like a spring breeze.
But yeah, no, like, you're not, you know, you're not gonna be...
Yeah.
You're not, look, you're not... Yeah, you're just not gonna have Shenmue.
Hey, Pocky.
Hey, Pocky. Bob Sponge, yes. Mm-hmm. Bob Pant Sponge Square.
That's right.
You live on a farm! I live in a penthouse!
Sponge.
Chuckle binge.
Oh god. Love opening presents.
Yeah.
That's the episode. Oh god. Give me a second off.
Fresh like a spring breeze.
Fresh like a spring breeze. I'm trying to do moves from Crash Bandicoot, but I can't do them because this ain't Crash Bandicoot.
Nah. This is a different entire game here. You know
this is a different type of game, Ryu. You have to do.
Oh, wait, no. You don't you have, like, one that. Can you just, oh, you're at the checkpoint there. Never mind.
Ryu!
Hey, Ryu!
You have to stop playing Space Harrier!
I'm sorry, I'm just very busy. I'm just very interested in this game right now.
I need to pass some time.
I need to get the high score.
You know what? Yakuza would be like a 10 out of 10 game if every character talked like Ryu from Imagine Machiba.
Here you go. Nothing like the smell of bubbles in the morning. Smells like victory.
Kiryu Chan. It's so good to see you.
I feel like a new sponge.
Oh. Hello, Goro.
I'm gonna race you in stop cars, Kiryu-chan.
Fresh like a spring breeze.
Not if I beat you first.
Thank you, sir, for winning me the chestnut.
Oh, you're welcome.
I can't get my mind out of that. I can't get my mind out of that
like
one because I hear chestnut. I think of fucking, you know, Dingaloo, Dingalee. You know, Chowder.
Yeah.
Oh, happy day, happy day.
Chestnut's got a hydrofoil.
Chestnut's got a new summer home.
Getting ear infections from you because you're so dirty. I miss Chowder.
Fresh like a spring breeze.
I know.
It was taken.
Somewhere right now. CH3 Red.
I feel like a new sponge.
He's working on season 3 of
Jellystone.
Yeah.
And he's gonna go. Hey, boo boo.
You know. People were so quick to judge the show based on that one episode where fucking Yogi Bear, like, kind of wars everyone. You fucking bastard!
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, right. Well, it's not like, you know, there's lives or anything, so I could just drop off the edge.
But yeah, I remember that one episode where Yogi wars the world.
We gave you an atomic stomach. Mm-hmm. Did you get the food yet, Yogi? I'm gonna regret not getting the milky chicken or whatever the fuck he called it.
Yeah.
The entirety of the cafeteria food sucks. You gotta live with the choice no matter what. Mm. Better yet, just pack your own goddamn lunch.
Yeah.
Get your own damn tauntaun, whoa.
Get your own damn milk.
C.H. Greenblatt crying in, whatchamacallit, Harvey yeah, Beaks.
I love opening presents.
Because every single, I feel bad for the guy, because every single one of his shows gets prematurely canceled. Like, you know, you could say, oh, Chowder didn't get a chance to go downhill before it ended, but like it was supposed to get a movie and that was going to be like the final bit or something like that.
Yeah.
And that was going to be like the play of, oh, we're going to see if we get like, you know, another season after it, whatnot. Speaking of media type channel, I actually unsubbed for Media Mementos.
Really?
Yeah, it stopped being a good channel. It just kind of became, like, ego-driven. That's what it feels like. It's just like, oh, man, my thoughts on this are the only thoughts that matter. All that for a sock, really?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm not gonna question it. Like, I'll put it to you like this, like, their last video wasn't even that great. It doesn't really, like, go into, like, super deep into, like, what happened. That, and I kind of had, like, my last straw of, like, oh, man, this interpretation sucks, even though everybody else seems to really enjoy it.
Oh, really? That sucks.
Yeah, he didn't like Green Eggs and Ham from Netflix, and I'm just like, why? It's not Green Eggs and Ham, and I'm like, okay.
Fresh like a spring.
It's a channel called Media Mementos.
It's not really that important in the grand scheme of things.
Yeah.
Met the Sponginator.
They used to have like really good content. I'm like, oh, this is like pretty cool. And then it's like, at some point when they hit like a certain number of subscribers, it hit like, you know, like, oh. And then the channel kind of got, they kind of surrounded themselves in like yes men, it felt like.
Yeah, that seems about the nature of the beast right there.
Yeah. I don't like, it's so odd, like, it's so odd when like, oh yeah, like this cool channel, it's like once they get like, oh man, I gotta have like this whole full stop. Like it wouldn't surprise me if they said like, oh, like Family Guy's bad and you should feel bad or something like that. You know, they made a video like that now.
There's nothing like the smell of bubbles in the morning. Smells like victory.
Oh wait, I got it.
Yeah.
This is such a weird frickin'. It's a weird part of the level. There we go.
If you have the bowl, remember. Get the bowl.
Dang it.
Yeah, it's alright. I had trouble with this one too, which shit.
Yeah. It's a bit of a pain.
You have to reset it.
Oh, I did? Oh.
Because it sets back and whatnot, you know what I'm saying?
But yeah, like two of their last videos were just eh.
That sucks.
Yeah.
I was thinking about that channel, oddly enough. There's like, oh, whatever happens in media moments. Like, yeah.
It was like two. It was like two things. Okay, yeah, so I gotta hit the. I gotta hit this first, then I gotta. And I think I talked about it where it was like, oh, they're like. His best video was the Charlie and the Chocolate Factory.
Yeah, and then you have to.
Wow, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, cool, and now I see what I gotta do. That is Kappa Mikey and Annette. He had like a lot of like really good videos. And then just kinda, you know. Animaniacs is the first where I'm like, huh. Then it was like, Right, I got up. You see the...
Yeah.
Zero out of ten. Dumbest baby. That thing just did that out of spite. It did that to spite me. Alright, there we go. Hopefully that'll take it.
Yep.
We need we need Big Mountain Fudge Cake.
Yeah. I am the Reaper!
Children die alone.
There's nothing like a smell of bubbles in the morning. Smells like victory.
Please make it.
Come on.
Yes, there we go.
Ooh! In a minute.
No!
Oh shit.
No! Oh! Can't believe I got this one on stream is the funny part last time.
Yeah.
This is the worst one in the game. Mm-hmm. Well, this is the worst one technically since they made the kelp forest beatable.
Mike! Look, boy, there's gold under that glass.
I got this,
Gold, I say! My eyes are getting sweaty just looking at it.
You just gotta be fast.
All you have to do is get that great big ball into that there cup.
How do I get the ball rolling, Mr. Krabs?
It's 3 a.m. and I suddenly have a huge craving for pizza. I'm sad now.
You start the process by bubble bowling up this ramp to hit that button. Good luck, SpongeBob. My wallet's counting on you.
My wallet's counting on you. Mr. Krabs, the front door is missing.
Right here.
Oh. Ah.
Mr. Krabs, which way do I live? Oh, yeah, right. go, or... There you go.
This is the worst. Yeah, this is straight up the worst one in the game. Oh god. It doesn't make breakfast. It fucking shoots you. It doesn't make breakfast at all. Rolling, rolling. Yo, I know you be loving this shit right here. LAMP Biscuit is right here. And then you find out they were at Woodstock 99. You see Fred Durst on stage. Guys, Durst's rallying up the crowd again.
There's nothing like the smell of bubbles in the morning. Smells like victory.
Damn it. Oh. Oh. Oh, fiddlesticks.
Oh, fiddlesticks.
Coach Z, 1-2-1-2. I want to see Coach Z try this.
Now, let's see what we have to do with this little thingamajig here.
You'd probably throw it at the screen, break it, and just be like, yeah, that's it.
Yeah, that's it. Thank you for joining me. I'll see you all later. Coach Z, 1-2-1-2.
Why do you eat the doo-doo meat? Remember he puked in the couch?
Oh yeah.
It was full of doo-doo meat. I puked
in the doo-doo meat.
He puked in the couch. Don't you fuck. I've become so dumb. God damn it. Alright, let me see. I'll put on Chuckle Vision while
we do this.
Music of Time. I can't get the... I can't get, like, the cloning one out of my head. The hello!
Yeah.
Right.
Speaking of ice of the cream, I actually have, a couple of pints of, vanilla Häagen-Dazs that I bought in the freezer.
Nice.
me trying to eat healthier and lose weight, I could not pass up the deal on, you know. Because it never goes on sale. By the way, Zig, I actually tried Half-Baked.
Oh yeah, what'd you think of it?
Good.
Good?
Like, I ate the whole fucking pint good.
Nice.
I thought I could save it.
Gonna save that.
I thought I was too. That would have been the perfect save.
There's nothing like the smell of bubbles in the morning. Smells like victory.
Okay, Pocky, what do you want? Oh boy. He's the star of the show.
Or the star of the shoe.
The star of the shoe. Kirby does a promotion for Foot Locker.
You see Kirby come in with the fucking, with the drip. Kirby comes in with the night keys and whatnot.
Kirby, that's a name you should know. Kirby, he's the star of the show. He's got more than you think. He's got maximum pink. Kirby's the one. He comes right back at ya. Give him all that you got. Give your very best shot. And send you right back at you for sure. Hey, how can I help you, King DDD? I need a monster to clobber that there Kirby. It's what we do best at NME. You better get it with a money back guarantee! Kirby, saving the day! Kirby, he's here to stay. Don't be fooled by his size, you won't believe your eyes! Kirby's the one! Right back at ya! Yeah! Don't you fucking... This reminds me of, like, a AMV I saw.
Yeah.
And it was, and this was before they were called AMVs.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, it was I'm Blue, you know, Dabba Dee Dabba Die, right?
Yeah.
But, it was Kirby. And they used clips from Kirby Right Back At Ya. Y'all listen up, here's a story about a little guy that lives in a blue world. And all day and all night that everything he sees is just blue like him. Inside and outside. And remember Kirby, like, you know, waving his arms in the air and shit.
Yeah.
Trying to find, like, information related to dark matter from, you know, Kirby and whatnot. Yeah. But, nah, I got, you know, I'm blue, dabba-dee-dabba-die, dabba-dee-dabba-die. Blue is the color I rock when I wear. Blue are the... Blue on my leaves and all the trees are too. I have a girlfriend and she is so blue.
There's nothing like the
blue
smell
are the
of
people
the
that walk
smell
around.
Like victory.
Blue is the color I like when I wear. Blue are the feelings that live inside me!
Ooh.
up yours, game.
Hey, Merrick, before you start it back up again, you want
to... Yeah. Let me put on... Video. Yeah, let me put on the Chuckle Vision. Chuckle Vision. Hello!
What on earth is the piano doing here? Drying up. Now then, Barry, these are the things I want you to pack. Is that all right?
I'm sure we can manage all this.
Really, why must you keep interrupting? I want to talk to the brains.
I know that they've played video games before and whatnot, right? I want to see them play this.
All right.
And try to solve this puzzle.
And you, just do what your brother tells you.
Something. Too late. I think I've done my foot in. Well, you better hop to it. We've got to get all this stuff boxed up.
Well, you right.
Want me to move all this lot? Yeah. Right. Where do you want me to start? Where you could...
do as I told you. What would you do? Well, I'd probably sit down until it's get cracking. We better do that then.
Well,
I'll
sit down then, and I'll get cracking.
Might as well start with a whole trunk. Trunk. I didn't know she'd come out here. Just get on with it. Right. Have you seen what's in this case?
Smells like victory.
What a nice tune, Apo. Huh?
What are you doing out here, might I ask?
Well, I was just...
You were just laughing about outside when your poor brother was doing all the work. I see. Just get back inside there at once and give him a hand. You haven't even shifted the piano.
You got sent back in time.
What have you been doing?
Fuck you!
Well, I'm here. Well, that's all right then. No, it's not. It's all wrong. What were you doing before you listening to the music box.
Well, wait a sec.
They literally found the Song of Time from fucking Zelda. I want to see an edit. I want to see an edit where it plays the Song of Time. Get that part right.
Found you. Right, my turn now. Aren't you a bit old to be playing hide and seek? That's what I thought.
Aren't you a little too old to be playing hide and seek?
In that box. Don't be silly, you'd never fit in there. No, every time you open it, it sends time backwards. Hey? So I just have to... I'm not going outside again. It's my turn now. Are you sure? After all, I found it. You're right. Tell you what, I'll toss it for it. Hang on. That looks like my two-headed coin. It is. I lent it to you last week. Sorry. Yeah,
I'll bring
it
here.
Thank you.
The two-headed coin.
Now, let's see if it works. Thank you very much. What for? Nothing. Thanks for nothing as well.
You're welcome.
So what were you saying about this box?
I'm saying every time you open it, it reverses time.
Sound like a bit of a song and dance to me.
If you insist.
Of course he's gonna abuse it. You're
a bit of a mover. That's why we're here. Yep. Looks perfectly ordinary to me.
Oh, here we go again. Hey,
Coco.
You know, you may be right about this, after
all. Yeah, Coco came over to me.
Oh,
she wants to sit on my lap.
Well, actually, I was just popping back up. I think Barry needs a hand with something.
I'm sorry. This is your last chance. I know I've had to put up with a lot for dear Barry's sake. But unless you get that attic cleared at once, I'm going to have to let you go.
Go where?
Oh,
oh my God!
And you can take these up to Barry. He must be starved after all that work. Now then,
take these up to Barry.
That piano shifted at the very least. You haven't got time to hang around, you know.
You'd be surprised.
She tried to pop up. She tried to pop up in front of me, right?
Yeah.
But I'm holding my, you know, I got like my controller under the table, you know.
Uh-huh.
She bonked her head into my hand.
Aww.
Where is she?
There you are, Coco.
Do you really want to sit on my lap so bad? Come on. You're not gonna get far sitting up here. All right. You want to play the game with me, Coco? We'll play the game for now, okay? But if you're gonna want to sit on the floor again, can you hear?
Not really, no.
She's trying to sneeze. De Coco, okay. All right, I'm trying to do a thing. So maybe, like I said, you're probably gonna have to go on the floor in a little bit.
There's nothing like the smell of bubbles in the morning.
It
smells like
victory. Thank you.
I'm a sandwich.
Can you help me get this shifted?
Get it shifted? Don't you know what this means?
Of course I do. This is a demonstrative pronoun indicating a personal thing close at hand. Alternatively,
don't you realize what we're
doing? Yeah, Lotus told the damn about grandma's moment.
The Time Lord!
Dr. Chappy.
Who?
That's the one. With this box, I could become a king amongst men.
What about everybody else?
What about them? They'll soon come to accept me as their ruler. Yes, I do some of my best work when I'm treated like a king.
Oh my God! Immediately goes to abuse this power they've discovered.
Humanity? He's the guy that lives at number 32. What's he ever done for us? So why should we do anything for him?
Well, anyway, I'm gonna keep all of it. I think we should give it to somebody responsible.
So you're not gonna let me have it then?
No, besides I'm not finished my sandwich yet.
Did you hear that bit about the doctor? Humanity. What's he ever done for us?
Don't you know?
Then with the box.
Only if you promise to give it straight back.
Of course.
There we go.
Yeah.
Coco, you're my good luck charm.
Yeah,
she wants to get down now. I could be a Time Lord, just like Dr. Chappie. That's the one. Who? Oh, yeah. I heard the Time Lord bit.
You know, yeah, now Coco.
Guess where Coco's situated now.
Where?
She sat herself on. She sat herself right next to my chair, and now she's going. She's going. You're going to Benjamin's bed. I see you there. You're gonna play the whole. You're gonna play the whole like, I don't want to get up. You gotta come under here to pick me up.
I feel like a new sponge.
Who? That's the one. I didn't get all the buttons? I thought I hit them all.
There's one more near the computer and shit.
In here?
Wait, did you already get that? No, you didn't. There's one more that you start to, like, you know, There's one more that's, like, hidden it. Wait, no. Wait. I don't know, I'm getting confused. I made this video test, but I think it's the most strong.
I'm just being an impet, but I think. I feel like a brand new sponge. SpongeBob just missing that abrasive side.
Yeah. Wasn't there a button like near the whole Rube Goldberg machine there?
I think I got that one though.
Did you?
I got that one.
Yep.
Hello.
Hello.
I like money.
And you can't go around with
a love opening presents.
Never not. What about that? What do you say?
It shines.
He said if we messed up again, we'd be dozing with the amphibians. No, he said we'd be sleeping with.
Oh, maybe I gotta talk to the computer.
Why would you wanna say that? We'd be hard doing it.
Like a
computer room.
What we're gonna do in the meantime? You can start shifting that piano. What about you?
I've got a plan to hatch.
I have regained control of the security system. Here is the reward I promised you. You have pressed all the security buttons. Now press the master shutdown button.
Uh-oh. Did you hit that bit there, Merrick?
He said if we messed up again, we'd be dozing with the amphibians. No, he said we'd be sleeping with the fishes. Why do you want to say that? We've got our doobies, always. Well, you bring that up with Dan next time you meet him, okay? What we're gonna do in the meantime? You can start shifting that piano. What about you?
I've got a plan to hatch.
I got a plan to hatch.
Yeah.
What the hell?
Uh-oh.
I think we shut off something we shouldn't have.
Well, neither are you.
Oh,
yeah. Fair enough.
Get back to the front, then.
Quite right.
Now, get our duvets wet.
You'll get a bit of a speed boost off. We'll have that piano downstairs in seconds. Don't seem to have worked. We should have fast-forwarded all the way down the stairs.
You are.
Sorry?
What's that?
I said we... I'm sorry, I thought you were...
Shut down. And we got a good checkup.
Hooray for justice in all its multi-splendor glory!
Yeah, well, Justy Boy, you also cut the power to the Mermalayer's VCS. That's Villain Containment System.
Is that bad?
Does Mermaid Man smell like sour milk?
Yes! Yes, I do!
Oh, no. It looks like one of the villains is broken free.
What's that? An evil doer on the loose?
Uh-oh.
Who is it?
Oh, shit.
Man Ray? The atomic flounder? The dirty bubble?
No, worse than that. He's your arch enemy. Prawn.
Prawn!
Did someone call? Oh, I thought maybe I was looking at superheroes. But now I see it's just a couple of pieces of gnarled driftwood.
It sounds Prawn! Like Larry the Lobster putting on a French accent.
Never forgive you, you madman!
What did Prawn do?
The worst thing you can imagine. He put all of Mermaid Man's white clothes in the washer with a red sock.
Everything I own turned pink.
Hey! How horrible!
Personally, I thought pink made you very pretty.
Really?
Sure, pretty stupid. Yikes. What is that yellow thing? Some kind
this doesn't even sound remotely similar to
I'm
Milkmaid
mold,
Man.
I'm a sponge. Mm-hmm. There's a cellular difference. A cellular difference!
Yeah, yeah. Thanks for the lesson, Dr. Science. See you later, Pinky.
Man.
Seven seas. Run. I shall not rest until you are captured. But first, I shall have to change from my secret identity into Mermaid Man.
You don't have a secret identity, you old poop. Maybe you better take care of Prawn while I take care of this.
I shall avenge you, Mermaid Man.
I miss the random science jokes in SpongeBob. There's a cellular difference! A cellular difference! Man, this is such a shame because there are some primo lines, Mermaid Man, but the actor needs to have his larynx removed.
There's nothing like the smell of bubbles in the morning. Smells like victory.
He's mastered the control of the robots. You know what? You know what the thing about I like Prawn? I wish he appeared in the show. And honestly, I thought he was an ice-related villain. And his elbow snapped like an enraged gorilla. Come on, he was the voice of Chris Redfield. But no, his only evil ability is basically a weaponized version of the Foghorn, the Foghorn alarm clock, and, you know, throwing robots, as well as throwing, you know. Mm-hmm. I got screwed over by the hammer. Don't you just love it when your health doesn't matter in a boss fight? I do like the joke, though, that, like, you know, he's the greatest villain, and meanwhile, look at him. He's only slightly bigger than Plankton.
I know. It's like, what, you guys can get Mandrake with the Dirty Bubble?
I feel like it would be easy to defeat the Dirty Bubble, though.
Oh, yeah, no, you just have to get, like, a fucking point.
Oh, that's the point!
No! That's the point!
But you can see him in the background screen, which is pretty cool.
Yeah.
You are not fucking doing that to me. Chris Redfield is. Chris Redfield, the guy from Resident Evil.
Yeah.
He punched boulders.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he punched a boulder. But nobody seems to let that go.
I mean, if you knew about his fucking strength and whatnot, punching a boulder and shit.
He got fucking slammed by, like, a bioweapon and survived.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, like, you know, the boulder is the part that, like, everybody...
That and never shutting up about, like, the fucking, you gotta continue the Redfield bloodline. I'm like, oh my god. I think that's what made that whole, like, scenario with the castle worse. Everybody thirsting over Lady Dimitrescu and fucking, you gotta continue the Redfield bloodline. Like, I literally played the game, and that whole scenario in the castle does not equate to lusting slash thirsting over fucking Lady Dimitrescu. The exact opposite, really.
I feel like a new sponge.
Oh, God. There we go.
Yeah.
Come on. Bubble popped on, even.
I have no idea.
If I had the cruise bubble, this would have been, like, dealt with by now. There we go!
Yeah!
No, no, not again! This is not fair! I got a frozen wedgie for this! Is this the end of Pro?
Now he sounds like Plankton.
Locked away again, thanks to you, Frankie.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if that was Mr. Lawrence.
Here!
Did he also voice Larry?
My sock, bro.
Yeah!
Next to a bunch of pink socks!
Yeah, he voices Larry.
Golden spatula!
Thank you, Mermaid Man. I shall always live my life.
Yeah, because in the first bit, he sounded like, you know.
Yeah.
Still here?
He sounded like French Larry, and now he sounded like French. Now he sounded like French Plankton. Mm-hmm. Wait a minute. That.
What's up?
It's funny that that's the case. He sounds like a wine. Oh, you found in the gunner. Bad part. In the bad part of town. Oh, no. Mm-hmm. It's funny that he sounds like a French Plankton, because another channel I used to watch before they kind of, like, just stopped doing stuff randomly, Morning Drawfee, they were doing a bunch of, like, bootleg, we're drawing bootleg SpongeBob, and they made Mr. Krabs was Money Shrimp, right?
Yeah.
And, Plankton was Money Krill. They just took the same character, and it was like a French, Kira Theory. Yeah, I remember Kira. What's up with Kira? Where's that last sock?
I'm not really sure. He started a Strong Bad School Game?
Ooh. No, you can't. No, you can't. Handle my style.
No, you can't.
Here, boy. I kind of wish we got another whatchamacallit game.
I know.
It's probably not in the funds at the moment.
Probably not.
The Brothers Chaps.
I love opening presents.
The Brothers Chaps.
Well, they had like a bunch of stuff on like Nicktoons,
like
right?
Spring breeze.
I know they did like.
Take that.
I know Matt and Mike did a few episodes of like, you know, Yo Gabba Gabba and like Wander Over Yonder and shit.
Yo Gabba Gabba was Nickelodeon though.
I feel like a new sponge.
Was it? Wait.
No, you think like they've done a lot of like Disney like stuff too and shit. You know what
yeah.
I'm saying?
I know they did like this little side thing off of it was kind of like Bumpers. Oh wait, you know something?
What? Was it like Two More Eggs or whatever?
Yeah. There we go.
Yeah,
there
I remember
we go.
That.
I was about to say like, you know something funny? People like went nuts like, oh, where's our Bumpers on our channels, right?
Yeah.
Meanwhile, like, you know, I know, as much as I shit on Disney mm-hmm. Disney, whatever the fuck it was called, the other
XD.
Channel. Yeah, Disney XD, there we go. Because they changed the name from Toon Disney to, like, other stuff. So Disney mm-hmm. XD, they got all of, like, the, you know...
Yeah.
They got Bumpers, but oh, it's not good enough for, you know. Granted, most of the shows on Disney XD were like holdovers from Canada and whatnot, but you know.
Yeah. Or like the more extreme shit.
It's just kind of like funny, like, oh, we want Bumpers back. If that was a channel that did Bumpers, oh, those Bumpers aren't good enough.
Why'd you ask for it?
Yeah, every fucking time I always run into like, it doesn't fit my comedy stylings. I'm like, okay.
Okay.
There's still Bumpers. It should be like a point on that, no? It's not? Okay, fine, whatever. Oh, I see something over there. That looks interesting.
Looks like a sock.
Hey Piper, how's it going?
Hey, how you doing?
Moistra Bert! I wanna watch that video now. Moistra Bert! I never miss the Sponge Me Boy. I never miss Sponge Me Boy.
Sponge Boy Me Bob!
I'm gotten high on bath salts, and I'm trying to eat me own face. Aga ga ga ga.
Oh, Sponge Bob!
Now, how to get some
bath
salts.
You got your ass handed to you tonight, really? What? Bath did you not salts. See what he just said?
Yeah, bath salts.
Oh my god.
Jesus, Barnacle Boy.
Oh, how to use bath salts. What happened? How'd you get your ass handed
so
to you?
Shiny.
Whoa. Sponge Boy, me Bob. I've consumed ketamine and I'm going to die. Ah ga 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 ga.
Ah ga 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 ga.
Sponge Boy, me Bob. I've contracted rabies and now I'm foaming at the mouth. I'm foaming at the mouth and I want to rip out your entrails. Aga ga ga ga.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't Mr. Crab overdose on ketamine in an episode?
yeah, no, and then he's like, you know, and then Patrick's like, whoa, Mr. Krabs, you're still doing ketamine? What the fuck?
Nah,
you gotta get on that new shit. Take a man's life.
How to get some bath salts.
Oh, you have to see Mr. Krabs. He's the proprietor of bath salts. Or as he likes to call them.
Yarr! Get away from me, precious little flower!
Oh, that's it.
What the fuck? Really?
I guess it's like a little thing where it's like, oh, hey, you got that? Well, here's a little thing.
Do you like the glitch? I'm actually kind of pumped for it. It looks cool.
Yeah.
Piper's got a new redeemable thing.
Oh, sweet.
A little glitchy version of this guy.
Oh, cool.
Mr. Krabs, number one proprietor of bath salts and Bikini Bottom. Away! Yeah. To the Krusty Krab! Away! To the table!
No.
To the double doors! Away!
To the broccoli!
Up, and away!
Be sure to give some extra broccoli to my young ward. A boy needs his veggies.
Here you go.
A robot go boom!
What do you think? Let's see before we look. Let's see before we look like we're trying to get it next door. Sure, aim for burgers.
Remember what the secret ingredient of the Krabby Patty is, right?
Yeah.
100% fresh ground plankton. Oh god, man, SpongeBob really fell down. Fell off bed. Like,
I know.
Now, like, alright. Like, I can watch, like, post-movie, right?
Mm-hmm.
I can watch, like, the post-movie episodes just fine,
yeah.
Right? Like, I don't think they're as bad as, like, people, like, go on and on about them. Yeah, pretty much, right? But I gotta draw the line. It was weird. I was watching on the mirror hours before you started stream. That's ironic, because like I said, I was thinking about Chucklevision as soon as you join, and lo and behold, you drop Chucklevision in. So there's that weird like video game / media, like freaking what's the word I'm looking for? I'm an empath for this shit. It's weird. I'm gonna play, like one of our next streams is gonna be Rayman 3, right? Watch. We're gonna play that, and a fucking new Rayman game is gonna get announced, and I'm gonna be like, it happened to fucking get- There's a reason why I have the Merrick soapbox emote. It's not because I'm a jackass who's full of myself. The unfortunate truth is I'm right a lot, and it's always like, why? Why must I be cursed with this?
Love opening presents. Hammer bite.
A real Cassandra.
Fresh like
I tell you, there's going to be like something weird that's gonna come out somewhere.
Yeah.
There's gonna be something weird that comes out somewhere because of all this. Next thing you know, we're gonna be watching.
Yeah.
boy needs his veggies.
Here we go.
Barry?
Sorry.
Oh, Larry! I'm Harry. There's only Barry here.
Oh, dear. I seem to have gone a bit too far forward. You just wait there, Grandad.
You're not my grandson.
Don't worry, Barry. I'll have you back to normal in a jiffy.
You're not my grandson.
You should go help Mermaid Man. He's in the villain containment area.
I already did it. It killed Prawn. Mm-hmm.
Climb adjustment. There.
I'm looking for a missing sock now.
Are away, little diddums.
Yeah, no, Monument.
Apart from a sub nose to suck my thumb and say dad, you mean?
No change there,
then.
Just a few teething problems.
You've been messing around with that music box again.
You already got the one.
We're
gonna
leave this alone now.
We're
gonna get this piano downstairs like we're supposed to.
You got the one that was, like, right on the lamppost and shit, right?
Yeah. In the main chamber.
Yeah, that's what I thought, yeah.
There's nothing like the smell of bubbles in the morning. Smells like victory.
You get that one during that whole obstacle. Yeah, I remember that. Oh! It's right under the fucking, you know that glass tube? When you have to maneuver the ball and shit? It's right behind that. It's actually, like, right on top of a, tiki.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Alright, alright.
Alright.
You love what you see.
I feel like a new sponge. Somehow I don't think he needs a hand.
Let me see this.
Who's a little liquor boy then?
So there's like young child Harry. Yeah, yeah, the mustache.
I can see why they say piano music's very moving now.
You're telling me?
To you, to me, to you, and then they just start going up and down the stairs. So to reset. That was fucking gold, actually. Should we save the best level? Should we save the best level for last, or should we save the worst level for last?
We should save the best for last.
Alright, it's time to go to boring old Sand Mountain.
Life is extreme, if that's how you measure it.
And he was never seen again. Maybe we sang it wrong.
Oh, there once was a sandman who.
To you, to me. Betty! Fucking those two chuckle nuts.
Yeah.
Oh god. Hey, there's the Sandman! Oh.
Sand Mountain, where sea creatures go to enjoy an afternoon of falling down.
Squidward, am I glad you're here. I need to borrow your toothbrush again.
What? You've used it before?
Oh, yeah, lots of times. I figured if you didn't know, you wouldn't mind.
Fine. What do I care? I'm a wreck anyways. I try and get some exercise to relax from all this robot mess, and now everything is ruined.
Because of a toothbrush?
No, it's those blasted robots! They've taken over the ski slopes! How can I ski with those ugly things beating everyone up? Listen, SpongeBob, you've gotta help me! I'm gonna lose my marbles if I don't get some relaxation!
I found if you keep your marbles in a bag, they don't get lost as often.
Why didn't he just go home and lock himself in?
It's lovely.
He lives in a fucking...
Forget the marbles! I've got a better idea. If you get rid of the robots at the bottom of every slope for me, I'll give you one of those golden spatulas.
Well, I don't know. It's hard to beat the extreme fun of marbles.
Okay. I'll give you one for each slope you clear.
Now that's a deal!
Daytona, let's go away, let's go away.
Take that.
Merrick.
Oh boy. Hold on. Ding ding. Hello.
Ding 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 ding.
It is I, Merrick, out here in the open. Let's go, yes. Soon there will be two.
The Guppy Mound. Oh, excuse me.
The Guppy Mound. There's people on the slopes, look like they're dead.
I've gone down this hill 100 times, usually rolling. Darn kids,
do the tricks, Terry.
Push me.
Yeah, don't be a baby bitch.
If you can beat my time down the hill, I'll give you a golden spatula.
So there's two challenges you gotta do. Mm-hmm. Wait a minute, do those robots have hams? Yes, they do.
Yeah.
They're called ham.
They're called hammers.
But be forewarned. Three hams will certainly kill him. Three hams.
Ooh.
fucking base, dude.
I was gonna say you start with three hit points, so... And then the retreat.
Three halves. Where's the...
It's right behind you. Pull this one and then there's the other.
I gotta hit the switch too.
Yeah.
I shouldn't feed him three hands. And there's a spatula at the bottom of every one for like.
Congratulations! You pass with flying colors!
Thanks! Well, there we go, we could already get to the next area if we wanted to.
Yeah. But do I really want to?
Do we?
Solo Rama!
Nah.
To me, to you. To me, to you.
Another find for Patrick.
I just realized there's fucking, whatchamacallits.
Yeah.
Hey, how many things are there?
I love opening presents.
There's like, what?
And then redeem. Wait, so wait, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah.
Mm-hmm.
There's two, that means there's two in every thing, right?
Yeah.
And two socks and everything, right?
Just my socks!
You've just met the Sponginator.
No. I don't know, there's ten in like... It did say like 10, though.
Patrick will be glad to have this
bag. It did say 10 things, so probably like... Maybe 3 in 1.
Nice!
Well, I got 3 now.
Yeah. Again, I'm not really 100% sure. I never really did get, like, all the stocks in this game.
Unfortunately, we gotta do that because it's part of the 100%. Mm-hmm. Well, it shouldn't be if there's, like, 3 in 1, right?
Yeah.
Gary. Ooh, the robots. Oh, there's 3.
Yeah.
So what's 10 divided by 3?
9. So you can get 3 out of that, and it's
So unless one has four, then...
3.33333.
I fly like the wind and float like a sea bee. If you can beat my time down the hill, I'll give you a golden spatula.
If you can beat my time down the hill, I'll give you a golden spatula.
Like a new sponge.
Let's go, baby. Oh. Oh, you know what else I watched earlier today, too?
What?
The, Mediocre Presidents.
We are the Mediocre Presidents. You won't find our faces on dollars or on cents. This Trouble is done, this Bill is his hands. This William Harry Harrison. I died in 30 days!
We are the beat. I love that. That shit's fucking funny.
I know.
I feel like a new sponge.
We are the forgettable, occasionally regrettable, casually presence of the USA.
Kill for a mediocre president.
Fresh like a spring breeze.
We are the media. I don't know why it's so fucking funny.
I guess it's just because the song is just like, you know.
I feel like a new star.
Touch of geography or shit. Turn in this like very like, you know. Joe Toonsy like thing.
The mediocre presidents, they're gone but not forgotten.
Wait, what are you talking about?
The mediocre presidents, they're gone but not forgotten.
Oh, you know every mediocre president? Name each one.
Can you? Yeah, I thought so. I thought so.
Fresh like a spring breeze.
Truman? Was Truman a mediocre president?
He did defeat Dewey.
Dewey.
Congratulations, SpongeBob! You
the future is now,
time.
Old man. Here. Here's a golden spatula for your trouble. You know what makes it good too?
What?
Just the fact that it's a whole song number about presidents that didn't really do much.
Yeah.
Like, only that can happen on The Simpsons.
I know.
You know what? That's another show that I really don't, like, really, I don't notice. It's like older new SpongeBob, where I didn't really notice like the quality drop off, but you know, it was different, but it was like, eh.
Yeah.
Cause The Simpsons can be whatever the it can, you know, it wants to be, like, I don't care.
Fresh like a spring breeze.
Like, I'm trying to think, like, what happens? Oh, I know, like, somebody got upset that, people legitimately got upset at, like, the principal and the pauper.
And I'm like, oh, but that episode's fucking funny. What are you talking about, upset? Armin Tanzaren. Isn't that a bit of a cop-out? Isn't it, Principal Tanzaren?
I should get going.
He defeated Dewey! I can't... That shouldn't be fucking funny. He defeated Dewey. Oh my god. I just think about it. Everybody remembers, like, George Washington. Everybody remembers frickin', Everybody remembers George Washington. Everybody remembers Abe Lincoln. Everybody remembers, like, Sam Adams. Well, most
Sam
of
Adams wasn't president, though.
Which Adams was it?
John Adams. And then there's John Quincy like Adams.
I bet you they all voted for him because he's like, oh, he's got the same name as one of the previous ones. Get him in!
Probably.
It's fucking like. Yes. That's the. Zig. You don't understand. That's the political comedy I need right there. John Adams.
Number one on the Bikini Bottom scavenger hunt. 3 years running.
Oh, no, no. I'm his grandson. John Quincy Adams. I think he was the grandson of one guy. No, he was just his son, his eldest.
Well, it's like you either get presidents that, you know, you get fucking, you get Andrew Jackson, they do the Trail of Tears.
Yeah.
Or it's like, you know, you get that, or you get like, you know,
William Harry Harrelson, who died in 30 days.
was his vice president turned president mediocre too?
I don't fucking know. Oh yeah, no, John Tyler, yeah. There's Taylor, there's Tyler,
like
there's
Buford,
and there's Hayes.
There's Buford.
And if you look at the, like, if you looked at a fucking, you know, look at this man and just tell me that this. Do you really see, like, do you think this man was great for, like, you know, some sort of, like...
John Tyler. Do you think he was ready to be president?
No.
I feel like, you see how his hair is, like, got that little curl in the front, right?
You're trying to say something, Merrick?
No, like I'm telling you, if he became, like, he became... Because you've seen what being president does to people, right?
Yeah.
Like, you've seen how it, like, ages them horribly.
Shines.
Because of all the stress, all of the fucking stress... The only person, who it didn't age is he who shall not be named. But then again, he's covered in fucking, you know.
Yeah, I know.
Shit. So there you go. But anyway, like, you see how it ages people horribly and whatnot, right?
Uh
Oh, by the end of his term, it was probably like, you know, like, and his hair was all like fucking disheveled.
You know, I read a good article on the Federal Times today.
There's Taylor. There's Tyler. Oh my god. I don't know why it's so fucking funny. Buford. You've hit rock bottom.
Wait, we ain't there yet.
We've kind of hit rock bottom over here, though.
Fresh like a spring breeze. Ow.
For what this place is, this sure is the rock bottom of. Oh, God. Ow.
Damn.
I got injured. I died in 30 days.
Fresh like a spring breeze. I feel like a new sponge.
The whole of me. The whole of mediocre president.
Look, it's Fillmore.
Who? He's just like Phil, but more.
You just met the Sponginator.
Say that about maybe that's why people didn't like The Simpsons. I'm just gonna let them say that about, I don't know.
Nah, nobody would fucking care about the presidents. Especially the mediocre ones.
Well, there's a lot of people who give a shit about the presidents now.
I feel like a new sponge.
Yeah, so.
Once again, The Simpsons was ahead of its time. I was going to eat that mummy.
Well, you should have read Mummy for the Dummies then.
You don't you find that
fresh
odd though?
Like a spring breeze.
What?
Like as a burial practice. Yeah, let's turn our kings into jerky.
I guess they thought, you know.
I love opening presents.
Better way to preserve them into the afterlife and whatnot, or some shit like that, you know what I'm saying? I have no idea. I'm not a mythologist.
Too pretty. Cat, take it!
This
is the tool they use to rip out the brain out of your skull through your nostrils.
The mummy.
Starring Brendan Fraser.
Yeah, I defeated three mummies in my time.
Yeah.
Or two mummies. Didn't they try to reboot that or something with,
Tom Cruise? Yeah.
Wait, that was actually a reboot?
A reboot, remake. Again, it was a remake of a remake of a 1940s film and shit. You know what I'm saying?
A remake of a remake.
Yeah.
Well, I would say that, like, you know, the Brendan Fraser mummy was different enough from the original to be, you know.
Yeah, no, definitely.
Well, number one, it spawned a prequel movie.
What, the Scorpion King?
Yeah. Like it was that good that they thought, oh, you know what, we can make like a history out of this. And then not only that, like they traveled to China to fight like the Terracotta Army.
Yeah, I remember that.
What year did that one come out?
2008.
Wow.
Yeah, because I remember being in the sixth grade when that came out.
Wanted to go see it, and it looked good.
Yeah.
Because I like the Brendan Fraser mummy. I wish I could ride the ride at Universal, but unfortunately I don't do roller coasters, so you know.
Yeah. I'm not gonna lie, when I saw the special effects for that and shit, because they did like a whole they actually did like a special on like NBC showing off like the whole like how the game. They did like, you know, like a whole like, you know,
fresh like a spring breeze.
What goes on during the ride and shit. And it was just like the one where it's like the mummy has like the guy like all wrapped up and shit and he like sucks his soul out. That really like fucked me over and whatnot. It's like, you know, as like an 8 year old and shit like that, you know what I'm saying?
I think I remember you talking about this once.
I probably have. Shit, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we were talking about, like, you know, fears and stuff, or like, what fucked this up.
Yeah, you know what also fucked me over too with the Grudge? When that fucking came out. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But then, you know, I watch it many years later and it's just like, huh. I used to be afraid of this movie. Because thinking about it now, it's like, fuck, it's like one of those movies where it's like, you know, pretty fucking weird, all things considered. Where it's like, you know, it's... I just find it weird where it's just like, you know, apparently, like, spirit died in the house and shit, yet it still knows like your fucking location and whatnot once you leave, and like in a fucking like, and it like calls you with like, you know, with only the number four and shit, because four in Japanese means like, you know, is similar to like death, the word for death and all that crap, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I don't know, I just find it weird that a ghost knows, like, where the fuck you live or where you work and all that stuff. Like, I thought it would just be like, you know,
they read your mind.
They know everything.
Or it's like, you know... Oh god. The bomb.
No, the robot.
The bomb bot. Oh, you got screwed by the cop bot, huh? Strong Bad's cool game for attractive people. Sand Mountain.
Woo-hoo. I love how they have to remind me what this is.
I'm the fastest there is. My time down this slope is unbeatable. I'll give you a golden spatula if you can beat me.
I feel like a new sponge. I'm the fastest there is, SpongeBob.
I'm the fastest there is, SpongeBob. And there's no stopping that. Bitch.
Hey, you! Patrick needs to do laundry.
You gotta live like me in order if you wanna beat my time.
Gotta go fast. Gotta go fast. Gotta go faster. Everything is getting faster.
Oh, SpongeBob, everything seems to be getting faster. What do you say was in this protein shake again?
I don't think I'm legally a
full adrenaline.
Full adrenaline. Adrenaline rush. More it's like you just have this moment of like you gotta like recoup and then you're just gonna be like
yeah.
Bull adrenaline. My time down the slope, SpongeBob. If you could do that, then I'm gonna give you this spatula.
Yeah.
I gotta like remind myself who I have followed on here, because I'm like, oh God.
Yeah.
I just took a look at my thing. I'm like, oh wait, who?
I haven't seen them live in a while, so I forgot. What you looking at, yeah. Benjamin? Still wait, they'll be back tomorrow.
Yeah.
Oh God.
Could you beat my
fastest?
I'm the fastest.
You beat my time. I'll give you this golden spatula.
You are crazier than me. Here, have a key.
Yeah. Here, have this key.
I'm not sure what it opens, but let me know what you need.
Whatever you want, this fruit. Want this nice treat.
Stone Ocean. I didn't get a chance to. It never crossed my mind. Basically, because I wasn't home alone without, like, chores. So, like, alright, I had to sit. I have to, like, okay, I gotta do this. I gotta take out the garbage. I gotta do that, this, that, then. So, when I did get time to sit down with myself, it's like, oh. Like, I'm not really watching TV. I still gotta watch it. I think I managed to log into Netflix on my computer. So... Oh yeah, I did, because we watched the Cuphead on my... We watched Cuphead on my, So I could, if I really wanted to, I could sit in my chair and be like, you know what, I'm gonna just sit here and watch this shit. Yeah.
I'm the fastest.
I'm the fastest there is. You can't fucking beat me, SpongeBob.
Oh, you bet that I can't. Wanna bet I can?
Wanna bet?
I'm the fat.
That was Wunderbar.
Not gonna lie, as much as I love Port 4, the way Part 6 ends in its latter half makes Part 4 look like Part 5.
Oh no, oh, I thought I could jump the
gap. Ready for another fantastic day.
I'm the fastest fuck there is, SpongeBob. I hate power. I hate beast.
Hello, beast here. Have a good day.
I'm the fastest there is. You think you can fucking beat me, SpongeBob?
Yeah, you know what, Larry? I bet I can take you on. I took down Kevin with my bare fucking hands.
I'm saying the latter half of Part 6 makes Part 4 look like garbage. And that I think Part 5 is garbage, but Merrick does. So I use that as a comparison.
Mm-hmm. I see.
I don't think part 5 is garbage. I just can't get into it. Like, I can I can respect what it's trying to do.
Uh-huh.
But I don't think that it pulled it off. Chunk of asses. I mean, I felt the same till I saw the bit with Pulpo and was like, well, if they're gonna pull stuff like this, then maybe that's worth sitting through.
I'm the fastest.
And admit I was right. Like, the man when it's shiny. I understand that. You know what I mean? It's like, I could sit through the worst parts of part 4. Mm-hmm. But like Golden Wind, as soon as I made it to the boat, and then as soon as they finished the boat, and I was trying to watch, like, the part where they're chasing after the truck, I'm like, I'm done. I can't watch this anymore.
Yeah.
And like that, you lost me. Same spot, Mary. Come on. Shame, because part 6 was one of my few stands. Oh, part 5 was one of the few stands of Infinity for one of the stats. Like, I tried hard to, like, you know, sit through part 5. In the hole.
I'm the fastest there is.
It might be worth giving another go. Like, I'm sure there are many who say the same about part 1. Well, there's a lot of people who say that part 1 is shit, but they ain't right. Because they want to get to the bit. They want to get to the bits with the fucking stands. So it's like, oh. Like, I have a friend who doesn't watch it because of part 1.
They're lost.
Yeah.
like the sound of like the cracking of the stone that happens when those boulders hit it. It's like there's an earth, there's like an element of earth that we don't see there holding up these like sand platforms. And then those other giant sand platforms is what, you know, the sand balls what break it down into.
Yeah.
Pizza going out. Come on.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
998, 999, 1,000. Ready or not, here I come!
I'm the fastest.
He just isn't having it. He got through 4 episodes and put it down, and I keep on trying to tell him. You just gotta get through those first 10 episodes, send in Diamond and the rest of the way. Battle tendency.
Yeah.
Like, if you really don't like part one, I don't understand how people could like Battle Tendency. Because it's more of part one, just with, you know.
Bam! Ow!
Joseph Joester.
Oh, I heard. Mr. Joester.
Go ahead, Mr. Joester. He sounds like a Canadian. Go ahead, Mr. Joester. Tell you what, eh?
Darby sounds French to me. Could be French Canadian. You know?
They're like Canadians, but French.
Yeah.
Oh my god, I was right.
Go, SpongeBob, it's your birthday.
I'm the fastest there is.
I'm the fastest fucker on this beach.
I'm the fastest.
Opening presents.
Canadian.
I'm the fa-
Go ahead, Mr. J-
It shines!
Whoa, it's a baseball!
Oh, that's a baseball!
Well, any dub is better than the Duang dub.
I thought that was just a translation, I'm sure.
What a beautiful duet.
There's no other place as pretty as this town. This feels like a picnic.
This feels like a picnic!
Ha 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 ha!
damn it.
You're American. Here's a video, though. That might help you.
I'm the fastest there is. My time down this slope is unbeatable.
I'm convinced that Larry cheated. I had a feeling
when the boulder is about to go into that hits that thing. Mountain and whatnot, it creates a cave and shit. There's like a cave that you can go through and whatnot. And if you jump it just right, you can make like, you can like, you know, gain some extra time and shit like that, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, you're saying where the boulder lands?
Yeah, where the boulder lands and whatnot. When the boulder hits the mountain, it opens up a cave. And then when you hit the sides, you can actually jump down that.
Boy, Patrick will be glad to have this back.
Nice
you
job.
Beat my best time. Thank you. Thank you.
Beat my best time. Here, have this spatula.
The way he says it is very funny.
Congratulations, yeah. SpongeBob. You beat my best time. Here's a...
You beat my best time.
Yeah. All set, bro.
It's almost 12, right?
Yep.
I can't take much more of this level right now.
Alright.
So we'll give this a week.
Okay.
Three more, so it's probably in like the last slope.
I feel like a new sponge.
I know there was one around that same path they took when you activate like the whole thing.
Yeah, I saw it up on the.
Yeah. Oh, there's one.
Hey, you! Patrick needs to do laundry.
I gotta try to get up there with Sandy, I bet. Krabby Patties. Sandy.
Oh, thank Neptune, you did it! Now I can go get my equipment and ski in peace.
Actually, I think that Patrick borrowed your equipment.
What? Who said he could do that?
I did. I figured if you didn't know, you wouldn't mind. Again.
Wouldn't mind? Of course I mind! It's only the most expensive skiing equipment you can buy!
He gone and done helped himself, I tell you what.
Anyway. He doesn't even know how to ski.
I want the worm now!
Oh, this level is kind of crappy, but hey. You can do the same thing, like... Is this a would you count this as a budget title?
Not really, no.
Oh, God. Absolutely.
Oh, you don't say. Well, there must be a way up there.
Again, I guess I also want to think that, you know, the reason why they couldn't get like Ernest and shit was, you know, because also too, like, you know, he probably wasn't available and shit like that.
Same goes for, you know,
Clancy.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have no idea why.
He was probably filming a movie.
Probably.
Well, they couldn't have gotten him back to do Mr. Krabs.
Probably not.
So I gotta jump back up there as Spingebill.
There's nothing a land critter can't handle.
You can do it.
Yeah. Meow. I love the fact that, you know, Sandy is upset at Gary.
Mm-hmm.
He probably insulted her somehow.
Yeah.
Gary's face!
Hello, my most favorite friend in the whole world. I found another golden spatula for you.
Oh, boy! Can I have it?
Sure, if you fall down to the bottom of this pit.
Isn't there a safer way?
It's always safety with you people.
Well, you kind of bought it.
Ultimate
Budgie experience!
Save and stop for now.
All right.
As I am beat.
I don't blame you.
I am beat for now.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, we'll be back in a week.
Yeah.
God.
Mm-hmm.
You think we learned anything tonight, Zig?
You know?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think we did learn a lot tonight and shit. You know?
I learned
about the mediocre presidents. And how you don't, how you won't find your, their faces on dollars and 1 cents.
I learned that, I learned that this game's a budget title. The hard way. Well, no, you know what I mean.
Yeah, I know.
Well, Chris from Resident Evil's in it, so there you go.
True.
I also learned that, that one part in the Mermalair is a pain in the ass.
Yeah.
And I needed the guiding help of the Chuckle Brothers and my pet dog, Coco, to be the Lucky Charms, I guess.
Yeah, so anything's possible with your lucky dog and the Chuckle Brothers.
Whatchamacallit, I got my Spectre Deflector. Oh, wait, why'd I turn that starting soon thing on? I thought I clicked the image slideshow. Eh, whatever, don't matter too much.
Yeah.
I gotta have that on next for next time. But, what can you do? Alright. Anyway, guys, thank you guys for joining us tonight. I hope you guys enjoyed. But remember, as always, be yourselves. And remember, mega lega hi, mega hidey ho. Mo, make a chai, make a mo, make a hey. Pickle barrel, come quiet, chimichurri, changa. That's a secret word of the day. Alright, guys, catch you all later. Merrick out. See you guys.
Night, everybody.